So the learning outcome for this lesson is to look at the Thames with the upper, middle and lower course. But before we go that, we're going to do a little recap on our geography to look at the river profile and the course of the river. So here's a diagram cut through, given the profile of the river, with the salt at the top on the top left-hand side, river profile, and then going downhill towards the sea. So we split it up into three sections, and it will be the upper, middle, and the lower. So the upper part will have mainly erosion, the middle part will have erosion and deposition, and the lower part, sorry, will have mainly deposition. So the middle part will have erosion and deposition. So the upper part will be tend to be faster running. It'll have rapids, it'll have waterfalls, it will have V-shaped valleys as it cuts through into the riverbed. On the middle, it will slow down, it will widen, it will meander a lot more. And as we get towards the lower part, it will slow right down. At the top, if there's anything in the upper part, if there's anything in the way, it will cut through. That's where we get the waterfalls. And it's always eroding in this section. So if you look at waterfalls such as Niagara Falls, that's been cut back about half a meter each year. But if we look at the Thames, because the gradient is a lot less in this diagram, you'll get less of the V-shaped valley, and a bit less of cutting through the valley. So there we go, the profiles in the upper tends to be more V, lower it'll widen out and it'll slow down a little bit, and then in the lower it widens right out and it slows right down, and that's where we get features of the soil falling out and getting sandbanks and deltas. So there's the three sections, and we're going to tie this in to the River Thames. So this next video is the opening ceremony of the 2012 Olympics, and it follows the course of the Thames. So the course of the Thames starts at the source, and there is a stone at the source, and then it flows from the source. Starts as a tiny river flowing down, and then it gets bigger and it cuts its way through the banks, getting bigger and slowly bigger. And it gets wider, gets a little bit slower, and this will be the middle section. Or the beginning of the middle section, and this is definitely the middle section here, and then through the end of the middle section. And if we look at this carefully in a second, this middle section coming into King's Reach, past the Houses of Parliament, and then quickly, if we stop here, we can just about make out the school. And this is the middle section of King's Reach through the bridges and underneath Tower Bridge. And if we come up in the air, and we can just see the middle section, and it looks like a incised meander with the Isle of Dogs. And we come back down again, and we down to the river at the Thames Barrier, and that's to prevent flooding, and we'll talk about that later. And from there up into Bow Creek. So the River Thames is down the bottom there, and it's one of the UK's longest rivers. So the location, it goes from Kemble from its source all the way down through Oxford, Reading, Slough, through central London and Southend, and then at the end it comes out into here, the Thames estuary. So that's the length of the River Thames. So the upper course of the Thames is fast. Or faster than the rest of the Thames, and that's where erosion takes place, and we saw that in the video. The middle course, it slows right down, and we get more meandering, and we get oxbow lakes, and we get meandering of the river. So during this section, which is the middle section of the river, we get erosion and deposition. So if we look here, as the river bends round, the water accelerates around the outside edge, erodes, and then on the inside edge it gets deposited. So we look across section of the river here, we've got the erosion and we got the deposition on this edge, and the river actually moves. It moves due to this happening. So if we look at some of this, Oxbow Lakes, it's moving around in a big ring here. See, it moves around the big ring here, and it's cut across and it's left these rings here, which are Oxbow Lakes. So this is how the formation of Oxbow Lakes. So we've got the river going, cuts, and it joins here, taking a more straighter course. Then the loop's abandoned and leaving an Oxbow Lake, which will eventually dry out. So if we look at the Thames further down, the Isle of Dogs, if this had been left without any population, this would have gradually gone across and made the whole of the bottom of the Isle of Dogs into a Oxbow Lake. So the source of the Thames is at Kemble, and there's a stone here showing the source of the Thames. And if when it rains hard, it will flood, and the flow of the Thames will be a lot more. And so the first part here, which is the upper part, which is just here, then it becomes navigable, so we can use the Thames to travel on. And then at Teddington, further down, it locks. So locks means it shuts off to the water. So below, the locks, it'll be a steady amount of water, and below it will be tidal. It won't be fully tidal because there's a lock further down at Richmond, which stops it completely drying out. And then we go through into the middle part of the Thames, and through the bridges called King's Reach here, around the Isle of Dogs, and through the East End, past Woolwich and further out. And then it go out into the Thames estuary. And here's a great view of the Thames with the Isle of Dogs with the middle course of the Thames and then the lower course going out into the Thames estuary. When it gets into the estuary, it widens out a lot. And in this diagram, you can see all the silt here of the sandbanks and mud bars of the Thames estuary where it's very shallow.